Howdy, hi everybody. I've been gone for a while. There's a bunch of Starbound raw footage that I'll work my way through. And there's a little bit on mods. I don't know. I may just put it up as is. Before I get into this, and I don't know if I'll ever say much about why I was gone for a while. But anyway, before I get into this, we are back about 8 days or so, and Wickerbottom's back with us, although I'll have to re-delete her. When I tried to start the game again, I could get into WX, but I couldn't get into Wilson's world after doing the mods. It crashed the computer, not the game, but the computer. So we've gone back in time to a save before I did any of the mods. Or I think it's before that. I'm not sure exactly. So anyway, what is the immediate cause of my resurrection is evidently Bill Bob Joy did a MrGmView mod, so I can't very well ignore that. Now, Cap Cuisine was the last thing I was working on in mods, so I'll probably put that up at some point. There we are. And I seem to be out of date already. So we'll see how that turns out. I kind of wanted to do Always On, but that whole crashing the computer thing's a real pain in the ass. I did do Shaggy, and I thought that they had done something with Chester to modify him, and all you get is, aside from the different abilities, is a character that looks like Shaggy, and I had never really cared for Shaggy either way, and Chester still looks the same, so I probably won't even bother to put that up. Well, wish us all luck. Bye, Wickerbottom again. Alright, character. MrGmview, the adept. Assuming all goes well, I won't die. Well, kiss a duck. There you go. Is well learned, good cook, picky eater. Also has a magnificent beard. Well, there you go. Now, I am going to do Long Summer in case I end up keeping this. I never know where any of this stuff is. I've thought about doing more deer cloths for the longest time, so. Of course, I'll probably get my silly self killed, but you never know. Try more deer clops and see if he comes in the winter instead of never coming. Please do not crash my computer. Okay. I haven't done comments yet. I've done a few of them. I guess there's, I don't know, maybe 23 of them. I've done a half dozen, so I'll work on those as I can. I do comments when I'm waking up or going to sleep or usually when I'm processing film. Oh no, I don't start with anything? Well, that's not fair. I want to start with stuff. Oh no, I've got the ponytail? Well, be still my heart. At least I don't have the heavily receding hairline. Which is pretty much like being bald, actually. Well, we're going to run around and do some stuff for a while. Did I get flint? Yeah. And for the millionth time, some people say make the pick first so that you can get more flint. I always make the axe first. Oh, usually. I don't always. If there were rocks nearby, I might vary that. Oh, I think I lose sanity if I don't have a hat. So, I should be picking these flowers. Normally, I don't pick flowers early on. Fudge, was that it? Uh-oh, what are you, oh. There's something about Don't Starve lately that overloads my computer. And it was causing crashes all on its own. What I'm trying to do with that stuff is get a garland. And I'll read the stuff that's in the Steam thing in a bit. Now, I'm just assuming that a garland counts as a hat. If you're new to the game, you want to collect sticks to make tools and torches. You want to collect logs to make a fire if you're going to make a fire overnight. You have to have grass and sticks, or grass and wood to get through the night, because you need some kind of a light. So you need to either be able to make a campfire or probably two torches to get through the night. Pine cones you can plant to make new trees. Seeds are food, but have very little value at all. Once upon a time, they had more. I've played the game so long, there are many once upon a time stories. Our overall goal at this point, aside from just staying alive, is to get enough gold to make the science machine so that we can make armor and a real weapon so we can survive. And evidently I have hat issues. Okay, we have... Bill Bob Joy. Oh, does this not move? Yeah, it moves. Okay, we did well learned. MrGmview is well learned, as such is not afraid of the dark or the rain, but he knows the true nature of monsters, which couldn't be any truer, and thus will lose extra sanity from them. Beard is rivaled only by Wilson's. It is just as warm in the winter, and he refuses to shave it. Oh. I had to appear for court for something that's too long a story to explain, and I actually did trim it, and things would have gone much better for me if I'd shaved it. Judges are what they are. Hits harder than most characters, but is weak in the winter. Oh, no! Now, I didn't remember that when I did the long summer. He is slower than most characters, but as such has a lower metabolism, which should mean that I go through food more slowly. Good cook. Everything he cooks has an additional +3 health boost. Now, like I said, I don't know if cooks relates to campfire cooking or crock pot. Although he is a good cook, he is a picky eater and will not eat any raw food or monster meat. Oh, so I had to cook the berries. That's cool. Good. I prefer that. Then I don't have to look all that stuff up. Most importantly, MrGmview gets nervous when he is not wearing a hat. And as such, he will lose sanity whenever he does not have some sort of hat on his head. MrGmview loves his hats and he is able to make his own Mr. Hat. This hat is his signature hat from the profile art. This hat gives a slight speed boost, is warm, dapper, armored, and unbreakable. There is a bug where Mr. Hat, the tools of the hatter show up as something else in the crafting menu, But they work fine, and the other images work fine. Now, I don't normally bother with that garland, so I keep spacing the flowers. Over time, you'll figure out how much food you need to collect and how much you don't. Berries are almost always a given that you might as well collect them because they'll replenish themselves. Carrots do not grow back. And in my games, I never know where I'm going to wind up in a starving state, so I don't like to pick all the carrots. They've saved my life a few times. Alright, dusk doesn't really count as nightfall. And if you haven't played it, Don't Starve is one of the darkest games I've ever done on video. I don't mean dark in tone, I just mean the damn thing is dark as far as light goes. I didn't get my 12 flowers, did I? Now, Kevin, the lead developer on all this, said you could explore at night, but he didn't play the game much either. So your circle of light from a torch is like vanishingly small. However, there's not much to do in the nighttime. Okay. There's more green there. Let me get the rest of those flowers. Did I read? Yeah, I guess I did. Okay, that should give us our garland. Rabbit earmuffs, straw hat's the first hat. We need a science machine, so. Alright, the garland helps with your sanity, but not much. But one of his debuffs is that he suffers if he doesn't have a hat on. Based on what I do in my videos. Now that cut stone up there will actually help us with our science machines. And that's a fallen adventurer. Pick it, then move. Ooh, a pick. I'll take that. Okay, nighttime. Kind of torn. I think I'll make a campfire. Because I need to sort this stuff out. Now, I've played, I don't know, probably about a year now. And I try to always sort all my stuff out the same way. As far as the first four items. That means you can make tools, those two items. Those two items, the sticks and the straw, mean you can make torches. And the logs and the straw mean, or hay or whatever, grass, means you can make a campfire. But those are the essentials to me to staying alive. So, I don't think it matters on the berries if we cook them or not. Of course, the only thing I think of the wait, I think I get a health bonus for cooking my food, so let's cook everything. Now, I don't know if that means crock pot cooking or just cooking. Again, this is from Bill Bob Joy. And I was planning on returning to Don't Starve, but probably later tonight. Oh hell, I shouldn't have cooked all those. Oh well, life goes on. Uh, right, all these stacks, that's 40, 40, 40, that's 20. Once you have a full stack, you're taking up another inventory slot. So, and if you do make a campfire at night, it's a good idea to cook all the food you're going to need for the next day, and that way be done with it. All right, gold actually is the next thing that matters to us. See, by cooking all those stupid carrots, I took a slot, inventory slot. Berries we'll eat before that really matters. Okay, map. I don't have a hot clue. Spider Scope, I believe, said that following roads will take you somewhere. Which is one of those Zen things that pretty much holds, whatever, follows through. Because a road inevitably will take you somewhere. Graveyard would be nice, but anything will do. Now, if we wind up in woods, we won't have grass, and if we wind up on the plains, we won't have sticks, so... And until you hit those levels, it's the 40 and 40s, you might as well gather anyway, so... Now, I'm just assuming I don't have anything else open. Oops, pick that up. Pick, then move. Work with me. Work with me, me. Oh. Now I don't know what I'm doing. Like I did before. Red mushrooms are poison. If you feed three of them to a turkey, he'll die. Okay, is that a... Now what we need is the boulders that are streaked with gold, which this is not. However, stone's going to be an issue too, so... I'm just curious what the hell this other... Alright, there's a road, and it's the start of a road. That appears to be, I don't know what that is. Are you a, well, I think I misunderstood what you were. There's an awful lot of green. I don't remember this much green in a world for a while. I mean, grassland. Or whatever you want to call this. Good grief. I'm going to end up killing a turkey with a pickaxe if this keeps up. Yeah, I thought I was nearing the land's end here. We will probably continue through the night tonight. Perhaps that way. Okay, let's take a moment and, well, Good creeps, there's a lot of flint here. Now, this world has not been altered by me except for the long summer thing. And my Maxwell world, I accidentally did a trap that instituted winter on day two, so it's not that I'm trying to avoid winter, it's just I have more fun in the summer. And since this is evidently me, I wouldn't mind continuing the game. That, and eventually Wilson's world is going to have to go bye-bye. Just because it's so dated. I'm not sure. There's a couple of glitches in his game that may eventually kill it. One being that the cave has somehow gathered three levels instead of the usual two. Oh yeah, see, we went over the line on the the grass. Where are we? Alright, I thought we were going to run into that. So evidently that's a small patch of forest. I've never seen this much green. That's unreal.
Oops. That's alright. Alright, that's what I mean about the torchlight not being, you know, like squat. Good grief, who made this world? Fudge and pickles. Starting to remind me of the days of the map tests. And it's raining, that'll put out our torch. Okay, maybe that way, but I'm going to keep going this way. Normally, picking up the edges of the map, not a big deal at first, but... What the hell? I can't do that. Why can't I do that? Okay. Where are we? Night's almost over. Good grief. Alright, what happened here? Okay, Savannah. Okay. You know what? I'm going to save and quit.
Just in case the game, computer, whatever, crashes. In fact, I think I'll stop filming here. Alright, there will be more of Mr. GmView. I want to thank Bill Bob Joy for doing it. I don't know how you thank somebody for doing something this awesome. This is really incredible. Where's my... See if I can get that picture to stay up. There you go. But evidently there are goodies yet unfound, so... And I'll be back. It's just, I don't know, there's a lot of things that came up. There's, my health hasn't been good, and there's some just really terrible things that have happened in the family, and it's just a long and depressing story, and I've never felt that's what games should be about. So anyway, you all take care of yourselves. Thanks for joining me on the ride, and I will be back and before 2 weeks go by. And there's like a crud ton of Starbound, and it's not because I was focused on that, it's just it's easier to play when I don't feel well or when there's things on my mind. I haven't been sleeping very well. So anyway, it's just too many things I have no control over. So y'all take care, and I'll be back.